Hi, this is Susan Haynes. I'd like to go through graph traversals. There are two basic ways to do graph traversals, and they are breadth-first traversal and depth-first traversal. So let me just copy down a graph that will look familiar to us, and this just shows how nodes are connected to each other. The nodes are just given numbers. And this will be an unconnected graph, so I'm going to have three components to this graph. Okay, so the first traversal that I want to go through is breadth-first traversal. And the idea of breadth-first traversal here is that you're going to have a start node, which we'll call S, and you proceed to flood through the graph by adding edges onto edges that you've currently discovered until you have completed a traversal through a component. Now, breadth-first traversal is actually implemented using a queue, so I'm going to keep track of the queue right over here. So this will be an intermediate data structure that I'm using to keep track of things. Now, to show how this works, I want to start with the start node is number one, so right here. Okay, so in breadth-first traversal, I take all the nodes that are connected to one that have not yet been visited, and I can tell if a node's been visited because I put a mark on the data structure to indicate visited. And I add those nodes to the queue. So here we've visited one already, and then I add the two children to the queue. Okay, and I keep cycling through this process, take the top thing off the queue, off of the head of the queue, and mark that as being visited, and add its children to the back end of the queue. So I'm going to add two to indicate that I visited two right here, and add all the children of two onto the queue. So I've already got three there, so I'll add four and five. Okay, so the next node I'm going to add will be the three, because this is a queue data structure. It comes in this way and goes out that way. So 3 has is related to 2, single edge between 3 and 2, but 2's already been on the queue. 5's already been on the queue. I add 7 and 8. So I've got 4, 5 from the queue from before, 7, 8. Okay, so that takes care of 3. Next thing will be the 4. This is what remains of the queue, and then 4 has no children to add to the queue, so we'll add the 5. 5 has no children to add to the queue, so we add the 7. 7 has no children to add, so we add the 8. The queue is now empty, so this is the trip, what I can visit, what is connected to node number 1. One of the interesting things that I can do about this is that this particular way of doing graph traversal will actually build for us a tree, which is rooted at the start node, 1. So 1's two children here are 2 and 3, and that's the children that I added right here. And then when I add the 2, 2 has children that I add 4 and 5. Right, 2 is also connected to 3, but I don't on the graph, but I don't add that onto the 3 because the 3 is already on the tree. Right, this is a tree that I'm building from the graph by doing a breadth-first traversal on the graph. Okay, then I add the 3, and 3 will have the, I've got the 3 already on the tree, 3 will add the children 7 and 8. Okay, then from the 4 adds no children. The 5 adds no children, similar 7 and 8. So here is the tree that I get that is rooted at 1 as a part of this graph. Now what I can see here for this graph right here and this graph right here, I see that G is not equal to G1, right? Not equal. So that tells us right now I have more nodes that are in G than I've put in G1. So you'll need, in order to completely compute the connected components of this thing, I'll need to find a node that is not already included in the breadth first traversal starting at node 1. I'll need to do a breadth first traversal starting at 10, and then one starting at 11 or 12 or 13, okay? 9 or 10, and then later on one from starting from each of these.